Welcome to Coffee and RPGs. My name is Solomon SK, and thank you for tuning in for another episode of MMO and RPG News Roundup. Hope you guys are having a wonderful Monday, but we do have a lot to cover, so if you guys got your beverage of choice, let's cover the news together. Cheers to you guys. So before we begin, I just wanted to let you know that GamesCon 2020, digital event set for August 27th through the 30th, the digital GamesCon, which will replace the physical event that was canceled due to the global problem that we are having, is set to begin on August 27th. So if you're interested, you could definitely head on to their main website at gamescon.global for more information about the streamed event. And I wanted to begin today's episode with something a little unorthodox, and this is brought to you by PCGamer.com. Work continues on a Fallout 4 New Vegas mod. And real quick, if you don't know what this is, there is a dedicated group of people or modders who are trying to remake Fallout New Vegas with the Fallout 4 engine. And there actually is a huge history behind this, but overall there was another group of people who were trying to do the same for Fallout 3, which sounds really cool, but they kind of ran into a hiccup, and I believe from what I know, that project actually is almost non-existent, if at all, because I'm not exactly sure of the intricacies of copyright laws and stuff like that, but basically, when they tried to remake the mod for both of these games, actually, they couldn't use the voice assets of the original game because it infringed upon, again, I believe, copyright laws and other terms of services. So I'm really glad that the work is continuing, at least for Fallout New Vegas. So when I saw this clip, I must admit, it did bring a smile to my face because everything about it felt and looked like New Vegas, but upgraded with the Fallout 4 engine. And if you're a fan of the series, I'm going to play this little part here really quick, and you'll remember what this part was.
Yeah! Who won the lottery? I did! Smell that air! Couldn't you just drink it like booze? What lottery? The lottery. That's what lottery. Are you stupid?
So if your memory serves you correctly, you'll notice that the voice for Oliver is completely different from the original, and that is not by accident. So to kind of get around the legal hurdle that I mentioned earlier, I believe the team for this mod is planning on revoicing the entirety of this game, and that feat of in itself is a huge undertaking because I believe the game has around 400 total hours of voiced dialogue, and so we probably won't be getting this mod anytime soon, but if they could pull it off, this is definitely going to be a labor of love, and I can't wait to get my hands on it. I wish there was a way you could contribute and help out, but because this is a mod on an already established IP, I think they're also refrained from taking donations because then they'll be profiting off of somebody else's work that obviously doesn't belong to them. So they're really in a catch-22 here, but man, it's like you have a very dedicated group of people who absolutely love this game, absolutely love the Fallout franchises, and this is the kind of fandom that this game has that I'm really glad to be a part of. Although at least that's what I read. I'm not exactly sure if that's 100%. Probably should talk to a lawyer, but I believe that to be the case. Now we head on over to altchar.com. CD Projekt Red may return to series story in the future, and we all know CD Projekt Red is working hard with Cyberpunk 2077, but they did say that they are going to make Cyberpunk and The Witcher their main, I guess, workhorse of the company. It goes on to read, CD Projekt Red may have plans for The Witcher game as Ciri as the main protagonist, according to principal writer Jacob Schmalek, I do apologize for butchering that, who said series story is something that they may have to get back into the future. And really quick, we head on back over to massivelyop.com. Ashes of Creation shows off pre-alpha footage starting a curious mage and some strange ruins. And one of the reasons why I wanted to mention this real quick is because they seem to be making a lot of progress. I know they were under a lot of fire last year, but they seem to be getting the ball rolling, and I wouldn't be surprised if the beta tests starts later this year, but again, that's my assumption from what I'm seeing so far. Now heading to MMOculture.com, Blade and Soul Revolution female warlock arriving in Korean server this month. I actually didn't even know Blade and Soul Revolution was out, but anyways, it goes on to read, while the Southeast Asia English server of Blade and Soul Revolution just launched recently, the game already had a considerable runtime in its native South Korea. It is the 8th playable class, which again is the female warlock, and it's due out later this month. Back on over to altchar.com, Assassin's Creed Valhalla, new details about skills customization and quest arcs. Assassin's Creed Valhalla will let you fully customize your longbow and raiding party, as well as hire characters you met in the game. On top of this, the games will feature big quest arcs and will start and end at your settlement, which I think it's pretty cool. Obviously, when I think of this, I think of Fallout 4 and their settlement system, so I'm not exactly sure if they have any commonality, but in any event, please do not make their version of Preston. I'm sick and tired of Preston always telling me a settlement needs help. But anyways, he goes on to read, Assassin's Creed Valhalla will have three gameplay archetypes, just like Odyssey, which had Assassin, Warrior, and Hunter. The Drakkar, sorry if I'm pronouncing that incorrectly, can pack 8 crew members and is fully customizable. On top of this, your crew will disembark and help in fights, but only for activities that are close to the water. And on MMORPG.com, World of Warcraft Shadowlands Alpha during pet battle changes. And really quick, it says, as indicated by Wowhead, several of these changes Blizzard had previously shared a thread, which appears to be deleted, in which they discussed abilities they're aiming to look at. Here's a list, but one of the funny things that I've read is, or it says, is the Jar of Smelly Liquid ability, which who knows what that is. And from Gamatsu.com, Reverse Collapse, codename Bakery, previews, trailers, and screenshots. I have to admit, that does seem like a funny name, codename Bakery. Like, are they... Doesn't seem like a game baking, but anyways, it might be just one of those obscure and weird JRPG titles. It goes on to read, publisher XD Network and developer MICA team of Sunborn Games Technology has released a preview trailer and screenshots for the July 2019 announced tactical turn-based RPG Reverse Collapse. And as always, you can check out their Steam page with their tags as strategy, RPG, adventure, anime, and story rich. Back on over to MassivelyOP.com, Closers adds Busan Chapter 2, Terra Console's May Festival invites you to slaughter sheep. Closers has had a recent content update, which includes the second chapter of Busan, which will raise the level cap to 88. There will be a 20% increase in item drops and XP every Monday through Friday in May. And also, Terra on Console has the Summer Festival and Awakening update. The primary event will task players with slaughtering sheep for fashion tickets, lamb bulgogi, and strongbox keys, among other items. Login campaign and increased rewards from Vanguard requests are added as well. So we've been getting a lot of free trials or free play weekends, and Fractured is actually doing something similar. From MMORPG.com, Fractured playtest coming to all registered users on May 28th. Key thing here being registered, so you do have to register in their main webpage. Spartial OS MMO's Fractured is set to hold an open playtest for all registered users on May 28th. If you are a backer, you can start the test early on May 26th, but everybody else just, again, like I said before, needs to register, and it will last up to or until Monday, June 1st. And sticking with MMORPG.com, Eve Echoes launched date confirmed. NetEase and CCP just unveiled the release date for Eve Echoes, the mobile spinoff based on the massive online hit EVE Online. Wei Su, senior producer at NetEase, confirmed that EVE Echoes is coming to iOS and Android on August 2020. And if you're interested or just looking for more information, they did provide, I believe, a 1-hour live stream from their official Twitch page explaining the different things that this game will involve via a Q&A with the developers as well. So here's a new MMO that I've never heard about, but it's pretty interesting, even if it's not my cup of tea. But sticking with MassivelyOP.com, Everland is a sprite-based social MMO about logging in and hanging out with friends. If you're looking for a 16-bit styled MMO that's less about an adventuring, murdering hobo and more about just hanging out with others, then consider Everland, a developing free-to-play, socially focused MMO that's all about, quote, just logging in and hanging out with your friends, end quote. It also promises some manner of character progressions as well, along with things like minigames, quests, and world activities. And just really quick, heading on back over to PCGamer.com, Minecraft sales now exceed 200 million, which is an insane amount of copies sold. I mean, you don't really get a whole lot of games that could sell that many copies, but good on them. Back on over to MMORPG.com, Camelot Unchained recaps 90-day plan while teasing next 90-day plan. Mark Jacobs from Camelot Unchained has recapped the current day or current 90-day plan in a recent blog post while teasing work for the next 90-day plan. and some of the current plans include visual improvements to CU using a new engine technology. I'm actually really curious about that. I don't know if they're using their own proprietary engine, but I'll look into that. As well as one of the main things, which is RVR battleground scenarios and new siege engines. As it says down here at the bottom, RVR scenario has apparently been undergoing testing in the last couple of weeks, so that's probably one of the bigger things, as well as a review of crafting system in next steps, as well as additional lore. Heading back over to Gematsu.com, Wasteland 3 Developer Diary 1 Character Creation, Customization, and Combat. It goes on to read, publisher Deep Silver and developer In Exile Entertainment has released the first in a series of developer diaries for Wasteland 3. The first discussed character creation, customization, and combat with lead designer David Rogers. Wasteland 3 is due out for PlayStation 4, Xbox One, PC, via Steam, and GOG on August 28th. I've actually never heard of this series or franchise, but if you check out their Steam page, they do have the tags RPG strategy, turn-based combat, and gore as well, if that's sort of your thing. Back on over to MassivelyOP.com, Blessed Unleash offers apologies and goodies for estate bugs and erroneous account bans. This is kind of unfortunate, but at least they're compensating the players. Estates were being taken down as a result of a bug players were exploiting. The alert also noted that 350 players' accounts would be temporarily suspended, but the devs also wrote up an apology that confirmed only 50 of the accounts were banned that were actively participating in the exploit. Those who were caught in the middle of the initial ban wave are getting written apologies, as well as a package of 10 sealed chest keys and 200,000 star seeds as well. I don't know if that's a lot, but there you have it. And back on over to MMORPG.com, Lord of the Rings players solve secret stones mystery. And I covered this a bit last week in an update where one of the patch notes says something about a secret surprise, and the secret surprise was decrypting a set of riddles from their forums that people got together to unsolve. But it goes on to say congratulations to the Lord of the Rings community on solving the mystery of the secret stones. Get ready to face the Shadow King in an all-new scaling three-person instance at Ascad Emzal. I don't know how to pronounce that. I do apologize. The Chamber of Shadows opening May 20th at 10 a.m. Eastern. And this is really cool. Sticking with MMORPG.com, modders bring GTA 5 one step closer to photorealism. I am playing the trailer above me, and wow. I honestly can't tell the difference between this and the Unreal Engine 5 demo that we saw last week. But really quick, the mod in question is called Natural Vision Evolved, which is a revamp of sorts to its original mod, Natural Vision Remastered. The developer behind these mods is an individual named Raised, though additional modders are also contributing to the project. And lastly, if you support Raised on Patreon at the $10 level, you can download the mod. It kind of makes me wonder, though, because I did just say when we were talking about Fallout 4 New Vegas that you're unable to donate to the group of people making that mod, or else they're profiting off of an IP that's already established that doesn't belong to them. But in this case, you can donate to Raised, at least. And yeah, so I don't know how that works. Maybe I got everything wrong, so I'll do more homework on that. And really quick from PCGamer.com, Destiny's 2 The Lie Quest is bug preventing completion. So if you are a fan of this game and you're trying to complete it, just know it's not your fault. Heading back over to Gematsu.com, Metal Max Xeno Reborn details new character growth system. And it kind of disappointing a little bit that it's only for the PlayStation 4 and Switch, considering I'm mainly a PC player. But it looks amazing. It has a JRPG element to it as well, but you also get to tinker around with larger tanks and robots, it seems like, which is always fun, but I'll keep you posted as more information about this game comes out. And really quick, back on over to MMOculture.com, Grand Saga new in-game cinematic trailer showcases game's backstory. I did have a look and it looked really impressive, but at the end of the day, it's still all cinematics. As far as I can tell, they didn't use any in-game assets. So I'm more interested on how the game looks and feels and plays more so than a flashy cinematic. But although I will admit, the cinematic is actually pretty awesome. Back on over to MMORPG.com, check out this features trailer for Solasta. I believe that's how you say it. Solasta, Crown of the Magister. And these are the types of stories I love covering, just learning about new MMOs and RPGs out there. But it does go on to read, upcoming tactical RPG, Solasta, Crown of the Magister, has just received a new features trailer. Having completed its Kickstarter, the team is sharing the features you can look forward to in the game, The trailer showcases how to create a fully customized party by choosing among a wide range of races, classes, and subclasses, background stories, and abilities to maximize synergies and potential while adventuring. And as always, you could definitely check out their Steam page, and it has the tags RPG, Adventurer, Strategy, Turn-Based, and Tactical as well. Back on over to MassiveLyOP.com, Final Fantasy XI wishes its players well for its anniversary and looks to events and stories soon. I covered this a few weeks ago, and its anniversary was pushed back due to the, you know, global problem that we're all facing. But it does go on to read, Saturday marked the 18th year anniversary of Final Fantasy XI from its original release in Japan, and producer Akihiko Matsui feels confident that the team is almost back up to full operations, and he believes that the game will be hosting and planned anniversary content about 1 month later than initially planned. And that concludes today's episode of MMO and RPG News Roundup. If you made it with me so far, I do appreciate it. The watch time does help with the algorithms. And if you haven't done so, please consider liking, subscribing, and hitting the bell notification too, as those also help with the algorithms, considering I'm still a relatively new and small channel. But in any event, hope you guys have a wonderful Monday, have a blessed night, and I will see you guys next time. Cheers again, everyone.